Now coming to the front view. Here you can see the front view as the observer is looking from this side. Front view will appear on this plane which is behind the object, and it will look like this. Again, for top view, we will get top view on this bottom plane as the observer will see from this direction, from the above. Top view will be get we will get top view here, and we will rotate this plane in anti-clockwise direction, right here like this. And let us consider this edge of the plane, and we will rotate it like this anti-clockwise direction, so we will get this top view exactly below the front view. If here is a front view, we will get top view in such a box. Okay, and similarly the side view. Here again, what we have done, if we are getting a right side view on this left plane, this what we will do, we will rotate this plane, okay, in the clockwise direction like this. Okay, so we will get the right side hand view on exactly left side of the front view like this. This is the front view. Towards the left of this, there will be right side hand view, because this is in the first angle projection method. While in third angle projection, what we do, we draw the left hand side view on the left side itself. Okay, you don't need to remember about the third angle projection, just keep in mind about the first angle projection method. If you are drawing right hand side view, draw it on the left side, and vice versa. That means if you are drawing a left hand side view, draw it on the right side of the front view, like it will be here. Okay, now coming to the next slide, let us see the first example. A cylindrical block of base 60 mm diameter and height 80 mm standing on the horizontal plane with its axis perpendicular to the horizontal plane, draw its isometric view. We have seen this in previous slide. Here our cylinder is of 80 mm height. That means front view will be exactly like this, just it will be somewhere like this, because here both the sides are equal, but our height is more than the diameter, so we will get rectangular of height 80 mm like this. Okay, got it. This will be the front view, and in top view what we will see, here we are getting a rhombus or cube like structure as our diameter or the cross section of a cylinder is circular. Here on the top view we will get the circle. Okay, and on the side view again we will get a similar rectangle of same height 80 mm, and the upper side or bottom side will be 60 mm, which will be the diameter equal to the diameter of the cylinder of the circle. And finally, by following this procedure, here and the last we will get isometric view of a cylinder, which will be like this. This is the solution. Now coming to the next example, example number 2. Draw orthographic projections of pictorial presentation, that is isometric view is given, of a machine component in first angle projection method. Okay, this is the given figure, which is isometric view of a machine component what we'll do, here we have given the direction of observer. Now by looking from here, what we will see in the parenthesis, this thing. Look at the cursor, this line, this up and this inclined line. Okay, like this. Here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This will be the first outline contour. Now you will also see these edges in the front here. Okay, the inner edges here, 1 and 2. Again you will be able to see this triangular surface here. We have drawn here, drawing it. This will be the contour. Then when we will look from the top, what we will able to see, we will able to see this complete as a rectangle like this. Okay, imagine, try to imagine this complete cubicular rectangular shape. It is exactly rectangular because one side is 75 mm and another is 63 mm. Again, what we will able to see, this notch on this slot here it is. Okay, like this. And this upper plane surface of this projected surface, this will be 20 by 25 by whatever the dimension we will calculate here. And this is another rectangular surface here. One thing I miss in the front view here, as this notch is not visible from the front view, from this side, we will draw this line in a hidden circle, like a hidden surface, and hidden surface is denoted by dotted line. Here you can see. Once you get top view and front view, just by projecting these lines at 45 degrees from here and here, with the help of ruler or even the compass, you can just by extending these projected lines from front view and top view, you will get the side view. As this is in the first angle projection method, we will get the left side view, this left side view on the right side of the front view. That means this, you know that this is the front view and right side of this front view is this one. That means our right side, observer's right side. Even though the view or the isometric, in isometric view we are looking from the left side of ours, that means observer's left side view drawn in the right side of the front view in the orthographic projection. Moving to the next step. Next topic is the sectional view. Before that, we will understand what the sectional plane. If there is any feature, internal feature, which is not visible from the outside in front view or side view, then we need to cut a object or machine component by an imaginary plane called as sectional plane. The purpose of this sectional plane is to make visible the internal features. Here, so in this sphere, you can see this internal feature. This notch was not visible on the front and side view. It is only visible from the top view. But we have to show it in front view and top view. So we will draw a regular front view and top view. Just we will denote this cut portion by hatch lines. This lines, remember, these lines are not perpendicular to any contour line, these are inclined and equally spaced. Now you can see that this dark portion is not shown by hidden line. That means in a sectional view it is clearly visible, and this red line is nothing but the section line. That means this cutting plane edge is seen from the top view. Okay, here, and it is denoted by a line shown in here in the top view, and at the edges or at the ends it is thickened. Okay, moving to the next slide, cutting plane. We have discussed it. Once again, go through the this portion is the cutting plane and this is the cutting line, cutting plane line. I have told you, and this is called section lines. These section lines are different for different materials. Here we consider it as a cast iron, malleable iron. The purpose of sectional view is to reveal the internal features of the machine component or the object by eliminating the hidden lines. I have already told you. Moving to the next slide. And remember that the cutting plane is a plane that is imaginary, and that imaginary cuts the object to reveal the internal features, not the real plane. Cutting plane line is an edge view of the cutting plane. We have already discussed. Here you can see that in the internal features are not able to see or not able to draw on a sheet just by a single plane or full cut of a imaginary plane. Then we consider a different type of plane. We will discuss those different types of plane in coming slides. Here, full section, offset section, half section, and broken out section. These are the types of sections we imagine. Now discuss about the different symbols used for the different materials in a section view. Section line symbols. Section lines are different for different materials. Following are the symbols for the two widely used materials like cast iron, steel. You can see there is larger space between two lines, equal space line. In concrete, it is shown like this, and sand and wooden. This may be used in a what you can say, if there is a die, you know. The common things each student make and we make, that we draw either very close lines or very space lines. This should not happen. The line should be exactly like that, like this. The space between the lines should be approximately equal to 1.5 mm for small section or small diagrams, and up to 3 mm for large sections. I have already told you the section line should not be perpendicular or parallel to any contour line. These three are wrong notation. This one is correct. Now let us see one by one these sections. We have already seen this full section in previous slides. Here you know, if the object is symmetrical, then we can use this full sectional view. The view is made by passing the straight cutting plane completely through the part. Then offset section view. The view is made by passing the bended cutting plane completely through the part. Even though it is bended, but it is completely passing through the entire object. You know, now we can see all these internal features like this one, and this one, even though they are not in straight line, by using this offset section view. In half section view, here we the view is made by passing the cutting plane halfway through an object and remove a quarter of it. Only we remove a quarter contributor portion. That means 25% portion is removed. And as we are looking from this side, only the cut portion will be seen in the left hand side. Cut portion will be seen in the front view here, not the right side view. If we would be looking from this side, then we have drawn on this hatch line on the right side of the top front view. Okay, broken out section view. What is it? The view is made by passing the cutting plane normal to the viewing direction, normal to the viewing direction, and moving the portion of an object, removing the portion of the of an object in front of it, like this, which I have told you. If we are looking from this side, then right side portion will be hatched, will be visible. Now in this not a complete section or full section nor a offset section is shown, only a broken out section. That means this much part is broken and only this much plane is considered. So because it is solving our purpose, no need to take full section or offset section. This is the purpose of this broken out section. Now auxiliary view. Here you can see that in this figure, this true shape of the real object is not exactly shown, or it is apparent shape is observed in any of the three views. Now that means neither in front view, top view and side view the true shape is able to draw. We are not able to draw the true shape. Here you can see in the top view we are getting the apparent shape of this surface. The dimensions are different, so auxiliary view shows the true shape of machine component, which is visible as apparent shape in simple orthographic projections of view. So that what we will do, we will draw a parallel line x1 y1 to this surface, inclined surface, and we will put a one leg of a compass to the intersection line between xy and this projected line and take distance 1. That means one leg at intersection point and another leg of compass on the 1, and same with the same distance we will draw an arc here. Similarly we will take distance of here to point 2 and keep one leg here and draw the arc. Similarly we will get all these points and join these points, so we will get the true shape of the surface, inclined surface. This is the and this plane is called auxiliary plane, which is inclined. Now the bill of materials or list of parts. Bill of material is nothing but the list of parts which are drawn on a single sheet. When drawings of a number of constituent parts of an object are drawn in single drawing sheet, a list of these parts should be placed above or beside the title block in the tabular form. It should provide the following minimum particulars for each part. What are the particulars? It is part number, name of description, number of quantities required, then material and sometimes stock size of a raw material, and remarks. Additional information such as job and order number, instructions regarding finish, heat treatment, tolerance, how much tolerance is given to particular element or a particular what can you say, age or diameter, that will be written in this in the box of bill of material and title box. And again the references pertaining to the jigs, fixtures, tools, gauges, etc. may be, if necessary, included in the title block or given separately in the tabular form. It can be in the title box or can be given in a separate box. Now look how exactly the bill of material table looks like. BOM, bill of material. Item numbers, part numbers, description, quantities, and bounding box area. Then we will look study the standard sizes of sheets which we generally use. Here are the sizes in mm, 841 by 1189. In the next figure you can easily see A1, A2, A3. This complete area, outer lines, that is 841 into 1189 is the A0, and exactly half of this is A1, then half of A1 is A2, like that, half of A2 is A3. You are familiar with this A4 size paper we generally use for writing or register paper in our notebook. These are the standard sizes. Okay, and this is how the title block looks like, and it should be drawn: name, date, material, which material is this, cast iron, wooden, something like that, tolerances, finish, owner name, the projection method, whether it is symbol, whether it is a symbol of first angle projection method or third angle. Generally in India and European countries we use first angle projection method, and this symbol should be drawn over there. Then scale, whether it is a 1:1 scale or lesser than that, we have discussed it earlier. This was all about the engineering drawing, and here we have find it out isometric scale. I will once again wind up. As all the edges of the cube are equally foreshortened, the square faces are seen as rhombus. The rhombus ABCD shown shows the isometric projection of the top square face of the cube. Here we have find out the scale, isometric scale, by dividing isometric length by true length, and we have got here the cube. That means the ratio is 9:11. We will write it in the title box here. Okay. Okay, thank you. I think you have got. If you have any query, you can ask in the comment box. Thank you.